السلام عليكم، شلونكم؟ يعني ان شاء الله زينين. نبدي محاضرتنا اليوم على الاجابه على الاسئله اللي خليت لكم اياها بالمحاضره السابقه. السؤال الاول كان يتعلق بالفيزيولوجيكال امبيجويتي على these two sentences: why are beautiful girls like hinges because they are things to adore. If you remember, phonological ambiguity is based on the idea of putting junctures between words, which is something usually very rare in everyday speech. يعني لما الواحد يحكي ما يخلي juncture. Okay. So who can recognize this? Who can understand this? The native speaker, usually native speaker, understand the main idea of the speech, the main message. I will accept the message on the basis of the context. By context here, I mean the speaker-listener relation and the time, the place. All these things are very important in understanding the message. Now, if we think about why are beautiful girls like hinges, translation might be useful here. You may say, لماذا تبدو الفتيات الجميلات كالمفاصل اللي هي الزقفال اللي يسميها مع الباب اللي تثبت الباب واللي تفتحه. شنو طبعا هنا بالجملة الأولى ما مبينة الجملة ambiguous، ما مبينة من اللي يحل الambiguity. الإجابة إذا كان أكو جنكتشر أو here there is a juncture, here without a juncture. So we say because they are things to adore. هنا نقول لأنهن خلقنا كي نحبهن. Okay. أو لأنهن خلقنا كأجزاء من الباب. طبعا هاي الجواب because they are things to adore كأجزاء من الباب. هنا وين صار الربط؟ الربط الدور ويا من؟ ويا الهنجز. اوكي الرابط الدور والهنجس فسببت ambiguity، بس هو المقصود اكيد مقصود they are things to adore لانهن خلقنا كي نحبهن. اوكي not because they are things to adore. اوكي السؤال الثاني كان يتكلم على syntactic ambiguity. syntactic ambiguity ها now If you remember at page 64, the lamp is so hot that cannot eat anything. The lamp is so hot that we cannot eat it. Okay. Now the idea here is that we have, as I told you, we have two types of ambiguity here. The first type is semantic, and the semantic ambiguity is explained already here because of the word lamp has two different meaning. It is this is what we refer to as homonymy. Okay, two different meaning. The first meaning is young sheep, and the second meaning is the flesh of the animal. Okay, so it is already explained here. But the idea of the syntactic ambiguity supposed to be resolved in terms of the how to use the expression so that. So that is a conjunction which is used to usually used with so plus adjective plus that, okay, or so plus adverb plus that. As if you remember, last year we studied this. Okay, so you say here, so is a place before a modifier. Modifier هنا مقصود بإما adjective or adverb to intensify its quality or manner. Okay, so this emphasis on the modifier expresses a remarkable situation. Now, where is the difference? The difference here with reference to the subject after that. Here, it refers to the lamp itself, whereas here, we has nothing to do with the lamp. And this creates a great deal of difficulty, of difference. So here, they say, the lamp is so hot that it cannot eat anything. يعني الحمل يشعر بحرارة شديدة لدرجة أنه لم يتمكن من الطعام. لكن هنا, the lamp is so hot that we cannot eat anything. That we cannot eat it. We cannot eat it. Okay. Here the it refers to the lamp, and we here has nothing to do with the lamp. لذلك الترجمة حتكون كان لحم الله حار جدا فلن نتمكن من تناوله. فهنا السنتاكتيك امبيجيوتي اللي هي ما مذكوره بالكتاب وانا سالتكم عليها بسبب استخدام الات والوي. يعني السبجكت ريفيرز تو ذا لامب ويراز وي هير ريفيرز تو ذا بيبل هو ار ايتينج ذا لامب. اوكي ناو ليت اس موف تو ذا توبيك فور توداي. اوكي توداي's topic. Today's topic is about the semantics of the sentence elements. Now, let me just try to introduce حتى نحكيها بالعربي اللي هي الوظائف الدلالية لأجزاء الكلام. احنا عندنا بالجملة باللغة الإنجليزية ممكن تتحلل نحلل الجملة إما بطريقة دلالية أو بطريقة نحوية. تحليل الجملة بطريقة نحوية مو شغلنا هذا لأنه احنا موضوعنا سيمانتكس مو سنتاكس. بس خلي نشير إلى حتى يصير فصل واضح بين السيمانتكس وبين السنتاكس. اللي إذا نحلل الجملة بطريقة نحوية يعني structurally speaking. So we say for instance the sentence is SVOO اللي هو structure of the sentence. يعني subject, verb, object, object. Okay مثلا she gave him a book. She subject gave verb him a book to direct and indirect objects. Oh, she likes English, SVO. Oh, she spoke fluently, SVA, and so on. هذا تحليل الجملة نحويا, structurally speaking, syntactically. هذا مو شغلنا هسه. احنا شغلنا شلون نحلل الجملة دلاليا. أجزاء الجملة نجي عليها جزء جزء اللي هي الأساس بالجملة السبجكت والأوبجكت والكمبلمنت النونس. نجي على الوظائف الدلالية لهذه الألمنتس هذه العوامل الجملة ونجي على عامل عامل ونشرحها. أوكي أول شيء خلينا نبدي بالبارتيسيبنتس رولز. نبتدي شوف هنا بس خلينا ناخذ التعريف هنا. Semantic notions are based on the assumption that the meaning of a sentence can be understood in terms of how people and things participate in real life situations. يعني شنو؟ يعني معنى الجملة ممكن أن يفسر أو يفهم عن طريق فهم الأدوار الدلالية للأسماء داخل الجملة. والأسماء هنا nouns السبجكت والاوبجكت والكومبلمنتس. اوكي خلي راح نبدي بالسبجكت. احنا نبدي بالسبجكت. خلي نشوف اول شيء شوفوا لي هاي الجمله. جون اوبن ذا دور. جون اوبن ذا دور. اذا نجي هسه احنا نحكي على جون هنا بدنا نحكي على جون. اوكي لكن حتى نفهم ال الجون او الوظيفه الدلاليه للسبجكت اللي هو جون هنا لازم نفهم طبيعه الاكشن. الاكشن هنا شنو؟ opening the door. The action is performed by or described by the verb. The verb is opening the door. بس انتبهوا هنا اكو ملاحظه كلش مهمه لازم تفهموها من البدايه. من نقول action نقول action معناها اكو حركه. اكو حركه معناها حركه من نقول حركه تغيير بالموقع او تغيير بالحاله أو تغيير بالشكل أو تغيير بالحجم أو تغيير باللون. تغيير transformation of the state. هنا شو أقصد بالتغيير؟ الباب كان مغلق تغيرت حالته من الإغلاق إلى الفتح فصارت action. فهنا صار عندنا الفاعل نسميه agent اللي هو the doer of the action. تبون إن هاي ملاحظة ما موجودة بالكتاب. حتى يكون عندنا agent لازم يكون عندنا مفعول به. يعني لازم يكون الفاعل doer of the action لازم يكون مفعول به حتى يأثر حتى الفاعل يأثر به ويغير حالته غير حركته أو يغير طبيعته حسب الفعل المستخدم. فإذا نجي هنا نشوف هنا الجمل عندنا John opened the door. The sweeper cleaned the floor. The floor شنو كان؟ كان dirty. غير السويبر تغير الفلور اللي هو الأوبجكت تغير من dirty إلى clean. منو اللي غيره؟ غير السويبر. Mary washed all her clothes. Her clothes, اللي هو الأوبجكت, كانت أيضا dirty. فماري غيرتها باستخدام الواشنج. فالopening, sweeping, العفو, cleaning and washing. These verbs, because of them, we have the doer of the action, اللي هم John, sweeper and Mary, وهذول نسميهم agent. Okay? Agent, أو the doer of the action, ما الذي يقوم بالفعل. زين. الدور of the action طبعا هنا التعريف مالته هو الانيميت ثينك that causes the action. يعني by animate I mean what? I mean person and animal. ف it is not الاكشن مو بالضرورة أن يكون person, ممكن يكون animal. تقول أنا the tiger killed a deer. A deer was alive and now it is dead. Who did the action? Tiger. There is an action here, the action of killing. Okay, and the cat chased a rat, and so on. These are called agent and animate thing, either person or animal. Okay. Now, the second one is the experiencer. Okay. Now look at this. John is very happy. Now, where is the action here? Where is the action? أو خلينا نقول, what is the action? What is the action? What is the action here? Is there any action here? What is the action? When I say John is very happy. أولاً, there is no object here. There is no object. Huh? Very happy is called subject complement. Subject complement. يعني ما صار فاعل وكو فعل معين حدث تغير شكل المفعول به. فاعل دخل بالحدث وغير شكل المفعول به. Now John is very happy. Description. You are just describing John. شنو الدور اللي قام به John حتى نقول عنه بأنه هو agent. مو agent. You are just describing. ليش؟ لأنه عندنا verb be. فلما يكون عندنا verb be أو يسموه هنا copular verb, لما عندنا copular verb, the subject is not called agent. It is called experiencer. يعني involved in the action, but not doing the action. Involved in the action. And there is no action. Involved, just, it is just involved. The subject is just involved. There is no action. Okay, so whenever we have verb to be, the subject is called experiencer. It is not agent because there is no action and there is no changing in the state of the object. وما عندنا object, there is no object. Okay. أو مثلاً مثلا نقول his wife heard a terrible noise. His wife, okay, heard a terrible noise. Now the verb hearing, هذا. The verb heard, or the verb look, or see, or smell. Hearing, smelling, looking, seeing. Is there any kind of action when do we perform any kind of action when we hear? حسنا to قاعدين تسمعون. شنو الأكشن ده سووا؟ شنو؟ كل أكشن معكم. ماكو عندكم أكشن معين. ده تسمعون صوتي. هل الأكشن اللي ده تسووه, الفعل اللي ده تسووه بالسماع ده يغير أي شيء بصوتي؟ ما ده يغير. Hearing, you are not changing anything. لذلك يكون أيضا شو يكون السبجكت هنا بالنسبة لكم الآن, شنو؟ You are experiencing, experiencer. You are experiencer. Okay, you are not agent. Okay, so if we have copular verb and if we have verbs with perception, idrak, cognition or emotion, okay, there is no action here. And because there is no action, so the subject would be called or is called experiencer. It is not called agent. Okay? Now, if we go to the third type of the semantic role, this is called, now, look here. Look here. When you say the flood destroyed the harvest. The flood destroyed the harvest. Okay. Now, here, the flood destroyed the harvest. There is an action here. It is not just like the experiencer. There is an action. But the action here is not performed by something animate. It is inanimate. اللي هي عوامل الطبيعة. عوامل الطبيعة. يعني لما يكون الاكشن animate, لما يكون الاكشن animate, ف animate هنا again, اقصد person او animal. لما يكون animate, فبالتأكيد حيكون subject agent. لكن لما يكون there is an action, وأكو change. Now, the harvest was destroyed. The harvest كان جيد, اللي هو الحصاد. كان جيد وما بي مشكلة تغير. لأن أجل الفيضان دمره. تغير شكله, أكو تغيير. نسميه هنا السبجكت نسميه external causer, اللي هي عوامل الطبيعة. لكن من نقول the gang destroyed the harvest, gang اللي هي العصابة destroyed the harvest. Gang here is what? Human beings. They are human beings. Not our agent. ليش؟ لأنه الجانج animate. لكن بنقول the flood was great. The flood was great. Not our experiencer. ليش؟ لأنه we are just describing. This is where to be. We are just describing the flood. It is not. It is not. There is no, for instance, action. There is no action. No action. There is no action. Okay. Whereas here, in the first two sentences, the flood destroyed the harvest and the gang destroyed the harvest, there is an action. There is an action. But here, the action is performed by something inanimate, whereas here is performed by something, by the subject, which is animate. That's why we call it agent. All right. Now, let us talk about number four, which is called positioner. Four, called positioner. Positioner. Okay? From position. Here, look at the definition. If an animate being is a stationary situation, or stands in such a way that no change takes place in its position during the situation, that animate being is known as positioner. إذن أولاً البوزيشنر لازم يكون animate لكن animate مو بالطريقة اللي حكينا بها على الأجنت أو على الإكسبرينر كوزا. لازم يكون الانimate in stains, ثابت. Stationary situation. Stationary situation. Okay. لذلك حسميناه positioner. شوفوا, Joseph is lying on bed. Joseph, example. Joseph is lying in bed. Now, think about again, think about the verb lying. What meant it? There is an action here, but the nature of the action is different in a way. يعني هسا واحد يقول لي إيه هو متمدد بالفراش يتخربط الفراش يعني يتغير شكله. إيه صحيح يتغير شكله, لكن هو جوزف هل تحرك معين, قام في جهد معين, في أفرت معين بحيث غير البيت؟ نايم. لذلك طالما هو ما قام في جهد معين, في أفرت معين, فطبيعة أو شكل الأكشن اللي قام به جوزيف ها is different from Joseph opened the door. open the door. Opening the door is different from lying in bed. Of course. Joseph opening the door is what? There is an effort from Joseph standing, having the intention, and trying to open the door to do something. Whereas her lying in bed, there is an action, true. But Joseph does not perform any type of effort in this action. It is stable in a stationary situation. موقف ثابت. لذلك هنا شو راح نسمي؟ هنا راح نسمي positioner وهنا راح نسمي العفو her. This is positioner and her we call it agent. Okay. Now let us have some other example. Look here. His wife is sitting in chair. The same. Lying, sitting, living, staying. شوفوا هاي كلها الأفعال. كل هاي الأفعال ما بيها أي action, أي movement, أي effort يقومون بها subjects. لذلك those kinds of subjects, those kind of subjects are called positioner. They are not agent. Because the nature of these verbs, of this action, is different from opening and closing, eating, playing, okay? Here, in these kind of verbs, there is an effort, there is an intention of doing something, there is a kind of movement. And there is something very important as well here. Look here. Joseph is lying in bed. Where is the object here? What is the object? Look here. Joseph is lying in bed. Is there any object here? In bed here is a prepositional phrase. And is lying here is present continuous. Now, his wife is sitting in chair. Where is the object? My father lived in London. As you can see here, what do we have here? In bed, in chair, in London, in a hotel. Adverb of place. So what does this mean? It means that lying, sitting, living, and staying, there is a kind of action, okay? But it is not, since we don't have an object, so there is no change in the object to tell that the doer of the action is doing something by all means in order to change the state of the object. Okay? Whereas her, we say, Joseph, her, look her, Joseph is lying in bed. Joseph opened the door. Okay? Now here is the difference. The door here is an object. Whereas lying in bed is adverb of place. So lying and opening her, two different verbs, the nature of the verb decides what kind of, let's say, subject we are talking about. Now, if we think about her, position, a living being, if we replace it by non-living, إذا خلينا شوف her, look her, this is important. Look at these two verbs. His wife is lying in bed. His books are lying on the table. Okay? Look her. His wife is lying in bed. And the second sentence, his books are lying on the table. Now, let us talk about these two sentences. Look here. Now, of course, the first thing is that his wife is animate. His books, inanimate. I animate. Are lying, the same verb. In bed and on the table, the same. embed her prepositional phrase, preposition plus object of preposition, on the table, preposition, object. Yeah, syntactically speaking, they are the same. The, semantically speaking, the difference here is his wife is animate and his books are inanimate. See? In the first sentence, if we replace by now, the first sentence, his wife function as positioner, but in the second sentence, his books function as affected participants. Okay? His books affected participants. Now, her, this is positioner. This is positioner. Positioner. But her, it is not positioner. Why? Because her, it is inanimate. Because, and positioner has to be what? Has to be animate in a stationary situation. All right? Now, this is the first note. This is the first note. The second note here, whether a living being is functioning as positioner as depends on the meaning of the verb used in the sentence. Now, look at these sentences. The nurse was holding the patient's arm during the operation. Okay? The security guards held the terrorist against their will. Now her, okay, let me write it for you. The nurse was holding the patient's arm during the operation. All right. Now, the second one, the security guards, okay, held the terrorist. The security guard held the terrorist against his will. Against their will. Terrorists. Against their will. Look at these two sentences, please. Now, the nurse was holding the patient's arm. Her, I'm talking about the verb hold. Her, hold. Okay? Now, translation here might be very useful. But before we translate these two sentences, let us have a look at them. Now, the nurse was holding the patient's arm during the operation. واحد رايح بغرفة مع المستشفى ونايم بالفراش بعملية. الممرضة تسحب إيده بدون إرادته لو هو ينطيها إيده خلال العملية. The security guard held the terrorist against their will. الحارس هنا لما يمسك الارهابيين بارادتهم شايفيهم شلون انتم بالافلام راسا الشرطه يلزمه ويشتفه ويتخطيه على ظهره ويخلي اللي ورا ويلزمه ويلزم ايده هاي بارادتهم؟ تاكيد لا مو بارادتهم. فهو نفس الفعل هذا holding وhelding نفس الفعل لكن هنا بإرادته وهنا مو بإرادته شوفوا against their will هذا شلها علاقة لا لها علاقة مباشرة شوفوا هنا in the first sentence hold means keep in grasp it is a tense verb as opposed to the verb of the action we can say for that the nurse the sentence was semantic role of positional هنا صار شنو؟ صار positioner لكن هنا بالثانية the security guard heard the terrorist هنا security guard طبعا دا احكي عن nurse هنا تحكي عن نيرس. لكن هنا سيكوريتي جارد صار ما صار شنو صار؟ هذا السؤال. هذا السؤال لازم تجاوبه. شنو صار سيكوريتي جارد؟ What is the semantic role of security guard her? Her we have positioner. What is her? Okay. All right. Now, number five is the attribute. Okay, the attribute. Now, remember her first. Remember this. How do Socrates semantic role perform by subject? صار عندنا agent أولا experience ثانيا external causa ثالثا external causa and رابعا positioner Okay. Agent, experiencer, external causer, position. هاي كلها شنو subject. Now look at this sentence here. This book is expensive. This book is expensive. Okay. Now, I'm not talking about this book here. I'm talking about expensive. I want the semantic role of expensive. What is expensive here? What is expensive? Syntactically speaking, what is expensive? Expensive is called subject, complement. Now remember, the subject complement occurs when we have verb to be. Whenever we have to be verb to be, we don't have object. I have just mentioned this. We have subject complement. So we say this book is expensive. This is called subject complement. Now, I'm talking about the semantic role الوظيفة الدلالية المن للsubject complement expensive. Now, the semantic role of the subject complement or the object complement of a sentence. Now the leaves turned yellow. The leaves turned yellow. Okay. We made him wise. Now look her. Now, the leaves turned yellow. Here I'm talking about yellow. And here I'm talking about wise. I'm not talking about this book with the leaves we. I'm talking about expensive, yellow, and wise. The leaves turned yellow. This is subject complement. Subject complement. Okay? And we made him wise. This is object complement. We made him object complement. Now, why do we call wise object complement, whereas we call expensive and yellow subject complement? Why? Because expensive had described this book. Yellow describes the leaves, whereas white describes him, isn't it? Expensive تعود على البوك, yellow تعود على leaves, and book leaves, they are subjects, whereas white describes him. That's why we call it object complement. Okay. Now, expensive, yellow, and white are called attribute. the semantic role or the participant role of expensive, yellow, and wise is called attribute. Either an attribute is the semantic role of the subject complement or the object complement of a sentence. Okay? Attribute معناها يعزى لها أو الصفة. صفة الأدجكتيف. أدجكتيف كلها أدجكتيفز. Expensive, yellow, wise. Okay? So her. Now we are not talking about the subjects. We are talking about the subject complement. إذن الأدجكتيف, الأتريبيوت refers to the subject complement and the object complement. الستة الأفكتد. الأفكتد. Okay. Six. الأفكتد. يا ابو والله افتهمنا الواجب سلموني الواجب عرفنا هسه ما تكون اشتغلتون جزوا لي اياها اخوة هذا الواجب هذا الواجب زين affected the affected participant in a sentence is that animate or inanimate participant upon which the action هذا affected حتى تذكروا المفعول به المفعول به اوكي هذا احنا مو قلنا هذا شوفوا السبجكت Subject, agent, experiencer, external causer, positioner. هذا subject complement, attribute, وال object complement. The affected, the object. Affected, the object. Okay? Object. فإذا من نقول object يعني إحنا نتكلم على transitive verb. بس أذكرها. نقول object معناها لازم يكون الverb شنو؟ الverb يكون transitive إذا كان intransitive ما عنكو object transitive verb okay transitive verbs فالverb لازم يكون أول intransitive ما يكون copular verb اللي هو verb to be ولا يكون linking verb okay لازم يكون transitive verb حتى يكون عندنا object حتى الذي يقع عليه الفعل منقول في العربي مفعول به الذي يقع عليه الفعل من يقع عليه الفعل راح يغير حالته غير حالته غير شكله غير حالته غير حركته شوفوا هسه هنا مثلا we criticized that leader yesterday I bought an apartment last week John is eating oranges شوفوا لي هاي ال شوفوا لي هاي ال الجمل okay we criticized that leader Okay, we criticized that leader yesterday. Tali. Yalla. We criticized that leader yesterday. Now, we here is the object. Criticize is a transitive verb. Transitive verb. That leader is the object. And yesterday is adverb. Okay. I bought an apartment last week. John is eating oranges. Now here I'm talking about the leader, an apartment, and oranges. I'm talking about the objects here. الفاعل اللي هو we, I, and John. تمام؟ هنا criticize انتقد اشترى أكل. Okay. حالة leader هنا تغيرت. بعد النقد حالة الشقة تغيرت بعد الشراء حالة البرتقال تغيرت بعد الأكل وقع عليها الفعل وقع عليها الفعل الفعل criticize والفعل buy والفعل eat فصارت leader apartment oranges نسميها affected affected اللي هو المفعول به حتى نصل المحاضرة طويلة خلينا نتوقف هنا وإن شاء الله ننطي الجزء الثاني ننطيها بالمحاضرة القادمة